Now, Shelley's novel arose from the ferment of radical debate that ranged from the nature of the universe to human nature, and which Coleridge described this debate as the second scientific revolution of the late 18th and early 19th century. Charles Darwin's grandfather, Erasmus, made a major contribution to this debate with his notion of evolution within plants and animals. The increasingly volatile debate about human evolution was set alight when, in 1816, William Lawrence, newly appointed professor of anatomy, stated bluntly that the development of the physiological organization of the body can be observed unbroken from an oyster to a man, raising a furore of debate over the nature of mind, spirit, and the concept of the soul. One journal reviewer asked whether Lawrence wished his audience to believe that all the eminent powers of reason, reflection, imagination, and memory, the powers which distinguish a Milton, a Newton, and a Locke, are merely the function of a few ounces of organized matter called the brain. Mr. Lawrence considers that man is, in the most important characteristics of his nature, is nothing more than an orang-utang or an ape with more ample cerebral hemispheres. Mr. Lawrence strives with all his powers to prove that men have no souls. Now, doesn't this sound awfully familiar? Clearly, William Lawrence was the Richard Dawkins of 200 years ago, and I don't think the debate has changed significantly.